We are here at in Wilmington at a meeting with Air Quality Management District about Assembly Bill 617 to try to address cleaning up the pollution in communities of color and low-income communities that are overburdened by pollution, surrounded by many refineries, the largest ports in the nation, rail, transportation, and the majority of people are Latino immigrants and, of course, low-income. Today was a meeting of the Community Steering Committee, which I am a member of. The AQMD presented their proposal. They don't have plans for overall emission reductions, and they are not setting pollution prevention requirements either. For example, in refineries, one way that they will definitely reduce emission, which is replacing the most polluting equipment at the refinery, which are boilers and heaters. Also, there is something in best available technology called wet scrubbers that they work with the one of the most polluting equipment, the catalytic crackers. And so we don't see that they're going to require all refineries to install wet scrubbers. So they have approve expansions of refineries. And with those expansions, we also have extreme crude oil that's going to be processed, such as tar sands and Bakken. This expansion that they approve put more storage tanks. And so we don't see also any regulations or how they're gonna deal with pollution. We don't see what they're gonna do to address volatile organic compounds. And so they need to correct that inventory. In regard to oil drilling, they need to support the 2,500 foot setback that is protective of people who live so close to oil refineries. I asked them, why, is there any reason why you are not including regulating sulfur that come out of oil drilling operation and maintenance, such as hydrogen sulfide, which all oil drilling is a basic, but it causes nose bleeding, it causes asthma, including other more serious, such as even cancer. And so, you know, they don't have anything about regulating carbon disulfide, carbonyl sulfide. They also talk about transportation emissions and from the port, and of course you hear the concern about idling and all the emissions that the distribution of the goods from the port, all those hundreds and hundreds of trucks that go right by the communities that are all low income, we call them sacrifice zones communities because they inhale all the diesel from these trucks. We are glad that they are addressing some issues such as continuous flaring by the refineries. Flaring emits an array of pollutants into the air that we breathe. They want to reduce that by 50%.